Hello YouTube, in this tutorial we will learn how to work with default arguments. Why do we need them? Well, here's the situation. What's gonna happen if you forget to type some target here? So save and refresh and we will run into error. And PHP is very good explaining where you need to search for error. For example, we have one error, only one, where in one ping function, and that's already enough to get corrections. And error is on line 9, so there you go, that's precise. And original thing, the function we are using is on line 3, so there you go, PHP is very accurate. Well, at least in this case. So yeah, default arguments, what are they? Well, they need to be activated where you forget to define something there. So how to say, how to state a default argument, like a backup alternative basically, it's easy. You just say equal. And here you will state, well, Google as a backup location, like a backup target. So now when we refresh our things, the thing will work. Okay, see, there you go. Now, can this thing work when you are immediately calling a couple of these things? Well, sure. You can call one function without arguments and another function with arguments, like Yahoo. So that's totally cool, that will work. So these functions will not overlap each other. They'll have results for both of those targets. Okay, so this here is result of this function and Yahoo, well, of course, down there. Right, so here's the question. How many of these default arguments you can have? Well, it's totally up to you, it's a custom thing. So let's say that we are going to get second target, which will be Bing, for example. Okay, and now that means that when you forget to enter things, both of these functions will be activated, both of these arguments will be activated, but of course we must use some operation down there, I forget to do that. And now we will have results for Google and for Bing. Okay, just a second. My ISP will probably block me, man. Yeah, so Google and Google down there. Why is that so? Oh, sorry, I didn't change this to second argument. So that was extremely dumb. Refresh and the thing will work. So you will see here Google and down there Bing. Why? Because that's the order of arguments. Okay, first Google and then Bing. And now let's use custom stuff here like Facebook. And what else? Yahoo. And now Facebook and Yahoo will be activated and this will like be in a background. This will not be activated because we have them down there. So these are backup alternatives, failovers, something like that. Failover operations. I think it's correct term in English, correct me on that one. Let me see what's gonna happen. Okay, Facebook, first one, Yahoo. Second one, and that works. So some people will say, well, what's gonna happen if you forget one thing here? Well, let me see. Okay, so we have one custom, and then that means that another argument must be activated from here. Why it must be activated? Because we constructed our function in such a way that it will always ask for two arguments. So if you have one custom, another one will be substituted from above. Okay, so this thing will be for that thing and so on and so on. So let me refresh and we'll just get results for Facebook and for Bing. Okay, Facebook because it was custom target and Bing because that was like in a background second target, yeah, alternative basically. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Now some people will say, well, what if I wanna state this as a first argument? Can I say, for example, second equals Facebook and that's it? So will this thing then be like virtually pulled down there if I kinda hard code things here? Well, let me see, we will get into some kind of error. Okay, so let's see what's up. And see, we have a problem here. So just don't use this approach, okay? It's a stupid. This thing will not be substituted, basically. So we basically tried to override this thing, and we hoped that this thing will be like passed down there, but that's not the case. See, in the results, there is no Google. There is just Bing and original custom target. So you cannot just do this. It's stupid. What's the point? You know, if you're going to do this like that, then probably the best option is just to create another function, you know, functions that will call other functions and something like that based on some criteria, you know, through if, else, if, and while, and I don't know, something like that. So bottom line, don't play around too much, keep your life simple, and if you need to do this kind of weird combinations, then at least separate your code in different functions and something like that. Well, obviously, I don't know what you're trying to achieve, but yeah. So, well, yeah, that's pretty much it, and as always, thank you for watching, and see you next tutorial.